Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that because we have met together here today, life may grow greater for some who have lost faith in it, simpler for those who are confused by it, more secure for some who would escape it, happier for some who may be tasting the bitterness of it, safer for some who are feeling the peril of it, more friendly for some who are feeling the loneliness of it, and holier for some to whom life may have lost its dignity, its beauty, and its meaning. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. It is so wonderful to have you here at the Cathedral on this first Sunday of Christmas. Many of you have sung Silent Night, opened the presents, eaten the food. It may not feel like Christmas anymore, but Christmas it is. Christmas it is for 12 whole days. We get to live into the season of Christmas. And I am so glad that on this first Sunday of Christmas, we are together. It may feel strange to you to hear the words from God, from John's Gospel, that first chapter in which we hear about the Word. It is an incarnation story, just like the story we hear in the other Gospels, more cosmic in scope and decidedly less cute than a baby. But we hear from John the beginning of the world, the beginning of you and of me, the beginning of what was and what will be and what is. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. In the beginning was the Word. It may be less cute, but this incarnation story fully encompasses the scope of all. This Word, this capital W Word, this capital W Word which brings with it grace upon grace. What a beginning. And it all begins with the Word, the Word. How hard this is for us. And no wonder why a sweet 8-pound, 6-ounce baby Jesus takes center during Christmas. Because words for us are rarely spectacular, rarely special. Words for us are rarely earth-shattering. Our words are mostly lowercase W's. Mostly ordinary. Some are spoken with care, but other words we carelessly fling about. Some words are spoken with love, but others with malice. Some of our words contain hope, but others convey a deep distrust, not only of each other, but of the world in which we live. Words for us often lack clarity through time and situations. with this word that is Jesus among us, before us, with us always. This word, it's creative. It makes, it is action, and it is most of all a word of promise and hope. In a world in which mostly ordinary words are cast about, how powerful, how utterly powerful it is that we have this word made flesh to reside within us, to give us life, to be the promise of life-giving light that even darkness cannot escape. A word that speaks with such clarity, such passion, and such force that we are not just made, but beloved. And not just beloved, but redeemed. This word emerging at the conception of the cosmos was and is and always will be. This word is impossible to overuse. This word, this light, this love, it claims each of us as its own. And we receive grace upon grace. To be claimed by hope, to be held in Jesus, the Word, shines through our ordinariness and shines through the darkness of these days and illuminates God's love for God's creation. We are bathed in the light of this love, in the light of this Word. In this season of Christmas, we get a brief 12 days to bask in this light shining upon us from the very beginning. May we enjoy, may we revel, may we delight in this light and in our very ordinariness. In our very ordinariness, may we share this light within our worlds, reflecting the promise and hope that is, from the very beginning, spoken for all people. May grace upon grace be upon you.